This video is on the topic of percentage yield. Let's start by looking at what we mean by yield. Yield is the amount of product that we get from a reaction. Now, there are different types of yield that you will come across. These are the actual yield, the theoretical yield, and the percentage yield. All mean something different, and you need to understand the difference between them. So let's define each of these terms. The actual yield is how much product is actually produced in a reaction, so it's how much product is measured. The theoretical yield is the amount of product that would be obtained under perfect practical and chemical conditions. This is the value that you could calculate from using the amount of reactants used. And finally, the percentage yield. Now, this yield compares the actual yield to the theoretical yield. Percentage yield tells us how much of the theoretical yield that was actually produced in a reaction. And as the name suggests, this is expressed as a percentage. We can use this equation shown here to calculate it. Don't forget to multiply by 100 to give the ratio of actual yield to theoretical yield as a percentage. This means that for a reaction that has a 50% percentage yield, only half of the calculated amount of product would actually be produced. It is important that you learn this equation, as you are not given this in an exam. In reality, a reaction will never have a percentage yield of 100%. So this means that we never produce as much product in a reaction as we calculate there should be, and there are several reasons for this. A reaction may not go to completion. For example, if it is a reversible reaction and the products are continually turning back into the reactants. There may be some losses during the experiment. So for example, some of the product might be lost from the reaction mixture during the separation and purification stages, such as filtration or distillation. Other losses might occur when the reactants or products are transferred from one container to another. Take filtration as an example. As the mixture of the solid and liquid is poured through the filter paper, some of the solid and the liquid are left behind in the beaker. Some of the liquid is also left behind, trapped on the filter paper. Finally, different reactions may occur other than the expected reaction, which reduces the amount of reactant or product. For example, gases in the air, such as oxygen, may react with one of the reactants to form an unexpected product. Or the reactants may combine in different ways to form different products. In both of these cases, less of the expected product will be formed, reducing the percentage yield. Exam questions often focus on the reason why the percentage yield is never 100%. So it is important that you learn at least two of these reasons. Let's look at an example of a calculation involving percentage yield. This question is asking you to find the percentage yield of the reaction shown. Make sure that you read the question carefully so that you can identify the quantities that are given in the question. This value is the theoretical yield, as you were told that this is the amount that has been calculated should be produced. And this amount is the actual yield, as this is how much was produced. Write down the equation for percentage yield. Then substitute in the values that you know. Now, as percentage yield is a comparison between the actual and theoretical yields, you must make sure that these values have the same units. In this case, they are both measured in tons, so we can substitute these in without having to worry about converting either value. Remember, the actual yield, which will always be the smaller value, will be on the top of this equation. Substituting our values gives us this equation. From this, we can then calculate our final answer. You will be awarded 1 mark for the correct use of the equation and 1 mark for the correct final answer. Think carefully about the answer that you get. Remember, the value cannot be greater than 100%. So if your value is greater than that, make sure you haven't divided the theoretical yield by the actual yield. This is the most common error examiners see with this type of calculation. The example we have just looked at was one of the more straightforward percentage yield calculations. So let's look at something more challenging. In this case, you were asked to calculate the actual yield instead of the percentage yield. Start by identifying what quantities are given to you in the question. This value is the percentage yield, and this value is the theoretical yield. As you were told, this is what you would be expected to produce. Write down the equation for percentage yield. Now, substitute your values in. Remember, in this case, it is the percentage yield and the theoretical yield that you know, which gives us this equation. Next, rearrange the equation. Finally, you can calculate the actual yield. Now remember that the theoretical yield of aluminium was given in kilograms, so the actual yield will also be measured in kilograms. However, the question specifically asks you to give your answer in grams, so you need to convert this value to grams by multiplying it by 1,000. With this type of calculation, students often make mistakes when rearranging the equation. But you do get marks for correct rearranging. That is why it is best to substitute the values in before you rearrange the equation, as you can pick up marks for doing this. Whereas if you rearrange first and do this incorrectly, you will not gain the marks. Finally, think carefully about your answer. Does it look right? Is the actual value less than the theoretical value? If not, check your calculation carefully. In summary, the percentage yield compares the actual yield with the theoretical yield. Its value will always be less than 100%, as the actual yield will always be less than the theoretical yield. We can use this equation to calculate the percentage yield, which you need to learn. Don't forget to check out all our other fantastic revision resources here at Save My Exams.